Christophe, first I would like to ask you, you have several cinematic forms coming together in this picture. I wanted to know, like, what was the greatest challenge in making that all fit together? Like, what was your process?
Yes, there is a lot of style. We can call it a drama, a melodrama, a musical, a romance movie. What was important for me is to create a feel-good movie, because that's a movie I liked really from my heart. I mean, but of course, in terms of aesthetic, it was very important for me to do a period movie with a lot of spectacular sets, you know, but not in an old-fashioned way, but with the modern means of filming. You know, that's why I work with Tom Stern, who is a wonderful cinematographer who works a lot with Clint Eastwood, and for me, he gives to the movie something I needed really. It's a very aesthetical way of filming, of image, of frame, with a lot of saturated colors, with a lot of movements, and mixing the style was not so tough during the shooting. It was most difficult for the writing, because we have several characters, we have three friends, we have one wonderful singer, one jeune première, like we say in France, and it was difficult to write this, because when you have several destinies, you know, it's something a little bit tricky to mix them together. But at the end, when they are really making this band and they are singing on the stage, it was really the climax of the movie, and that's why I think for the spectator, it's a like a funfair experience, and that was my objective.
Je comprends bien, t'es avec nous?
Je vois pas, t'es deux pioches.
Galapia nous a donné un mois. Un mois pour réussir, Jojo. Le Chansonia est dans un sale état. On y travaille de l'aube jusqu'à minuit. Mais à nous seuls, on n'y sera jamais arrivé.
Allez, on y est presque.
Il y a ce coup, les gars.
Ils sont tous revenus. Ils sont tous heureux de travailler à nouveau, même pour rien, en attendant les premières rentrées. Même ton copain Clément est venu pour nous aider. Tu lui manques, je crois.
Faites gaffe, les gars. Ça me file le vertige.
Ah bah, regarde ailleurs.
J'ai cru comprendre que tu faisais un peu d'accordéon. J'espère que tu me joueras un air ou deux, bientôt. Tu me manques tellement. Je t'embrasse fort, papa.
How important was it for you to find this jewel in the rough, Nora, and have her, you know, give such a great performance? And for you, how, when you heard of the script, knowing that you were a beautiful singer, did you feel confident that this was going to be the picture for you?
Oh, I really wanted to succeed, you know. It was like before meeting Christophe, I was doing a few things, a lot of auditions and for TV shows. And when I heard about that audition, I felt like I had to see, there was like that singing part and acting part, dancing part, and it was like a dream, you know. And I didn't really believe that I could be a part of this movie, you know. And first I did that acting audition because Christophe thought that I was too young to play the lead character. So he said to me, okay, you're a singer, you can do a smaller audition to play a smaller part in my movie. So it was a dream too, you know, to have just a small part in that movie. Right. And after the singing audition, I did the acting audition, and after a screening test, dressed up like 30s clothes, and he finally said, okay, would you like to be a part of the movie, and would you like to play the lead character? And it was like a, I thought I was like in a dream.
Il est pris, hein?
Ah ouais.
Eh bien,
suivant.
C'est la jeune fille envoyée par Monsieur Galapia.
Ah ben, ça y est.
Ah, qu'est-ce qu'elle sait faire, cette traînée?
On va savoir. Envoyé au boxon vite fait, tu vas voir.
Bonjour, mademoiselle. Vous vous appelez comment?
Douce.
Pardon?
Douce.
Et qu'est-ce que vous pouvez nous montrer?
C'est méchant.
Ce que vous voulez, je peux vous chanter une chanson?
Non, merci, non. Pour chanter, il y a ce qu'on appelle des chanteuses. Chacun sa spécialité.
Alors, je peux peut-être vous dire une réclame? Une réclame de la TSF?
Bon, continuez à perdre votre temps.
Milou, allez-y, dites votre réclame, mademoiselle.
Que ce soit au coin du feu, pour un soir de gala, soit pour mon seul amoureux, ou le public de l'opéra. J'utilise la crème Simon, qui me rend attirante et belle, et comme toutes les demoiselles. Je remercie la crème Simon,
présentatrice.
Alors, vous pensez qu'en bête? Bah oui.
Est-ce que vous pourriez nous montrer vos jambes, s'il vous plaît?
Oui, quand même.
On vous engage.
It was a perfect match.
Yes, but it was very important for the movie for me because I had some very famous actors on one part, male characters, and for me, as she was, the character of Douce is a beginner, she's a newcomer, she comes to succeed in Paris, and I think that the parallelism with real life and the movie was a great experience. Mm-hmm.
Speaking of parallelism, you speak a lot of poetic realism in this movie, and I know that it's the city is somewhat fictional, but the time was real. Paris in the 30s was going through a lot of economic hardship, as is the world and acutely America right now. Do you think that was just perfect timing? I know you had the picture option for a while that this movie would be released, and now, you know, it's kind of like people could see themselves in the movie with the unemployment and everything else. Do you think the timing just came together perfectly for?
Oh yes, you know, I think first of all that unemployment is unfortunately from every times, you know, it's doesn't really, it's from today or from the other day, but I think there is a similarity who was not expected. In the 30s, it was a big crisis in France, but the election of the Prime Minister Léon Blum represented a big hope, a wonderful hope for wonderful tomorrows. And from what I saw from a foreign country in France, when I was looking to the image of America during the election of Barack Obama, they were also living a tough crisis, but I saw on every faces of the American people a great smile, exactly like the French were smiling in the 30s. Mm.
Now, why do you think it is that in times of economic strife that people still kind of pour themselves into entertainment? Like, for instance, this year, baseball has had more ticket sales than ever. And here in Paris, you know, people are unemployed, but they wanted to go be entertained at this musical hall by Deuce.
Yeah, they're very funny because in period of crisis, you know, the people are not buying cars, there are difficulties to buy flats or houses, but they go to the movie, they go to the shows. And we see it in France, there is crisis, but people are going to the cinema, they want to have entertainment. And that was the story of them, these characters in the movie. They are facing a huge crisis, they are unemployed, so what do they decide to make a living? To go on stage, to sing, because maybe by singing, it will be kind of the concretization of their objectives, which just to restore their dignity.